Hello, I'm Dr. Mansukh Gala, practicing in Gala Skin and Hair Clinic in Central Mumbai. Hair is a very important organ of the body, and proper care of hair is, as a daily routine, is very important to maintain its structure and its color and shine. Now, normally when we go out, there are a lot of environment pollutants, dust, etc., which cover the hair. Also, there is secretion of sebum from the sebaceous glands which accompany the hair, and these all collect bacteria and fungi on the hair. So, daily washing is also very important. Now, normally you use a shampoo to wash your hairs, and selection of the shampoo also becomes very important. A normal shampoo contains a detergent, something like lauryl sulfate, which acts like a soap to remove the dirt, bacteria, fungi, etc. from the hair and scalp. So, if you have normal hair, a normal shampoo containing lauryl sulfate is good enough. So, normally you wash your hairs with warm water first, apply a little shampoo to the hairs right from the base, that is from the roots to the tip of the hairs. Keep the shampoo for a few minutes and then rinse it off. It's always best not to rub too harshly with the shampoo in a circular fashion, which most people do. This might sometimes cause tangling of the hairs. You can apply a conditioner if required after you have washed off the shampoo if your hairs are dry. The conditioner again is also applied in the same fashion, but when you are applying the conditioner, the tips are more important, because most of the time the tips have become dry, brittle, and they start splitting up. So the conditioner should be applied more at the tips, and then try to keep it for a few minutes again, say around 8-10 minutes, and then wash off the conditioner with little cool water. Now, nowadays a lot of shampoos are also available with conditioners in themselves. This could be okay. If you are using regularly, a shampoo cum conditioner is also okay. If you have very dry, thin hair, then there are weaker shampoos, as we call them, milder shampoos, which contain betaines or quartz, as they are called, and they can be less harmful to the hair if they are used regularly. The question is, how often do you wash your hairs? Now, many a times people wash daily if the hair is very oily or they have gone out too frequently. But if you have normal hair, then probably, according to me, twice a week shampooing is more than sufficient. Many a times you may have dandruff, or you may have seborrheic dermatitis, what is called eczema of the scalp, or you may have psoriasis. Then you can add some medicines to your shampoos, like say ketoconazole, zinc pyrithione, tar derivatives, etc. So these shampoos are little more stronger as compared to your normal shampoos. So according to the disease, according to the severity of the disease, you can use them maybe twice, thrice a week, and then start maintaining them at least once a week. Rest of the week, you can use the rest of the days, you can use the normal shampoos. Once you have cleaned, once you have shampooed your hairs and used the conditioners, what else do you do the hairs? So don't try to rub them too harshly with a comb or with a brush. Be very gentle, be very mild. Use your fingers first to remove the tangles or remove the knots, and then use a wide toothed comb. Later on, you can use a small fine brush to style your hairs. Is oiling important? Now, this is a very big question. Most of us doctors usually advise not to apply oil, for the simple reason already sebum is secreted from your sebaceous glands, which makes the hair oily. You apply more oil, you are inviting more bacteria and more fungus to the scalp, and that can increase the dandruff, the seborrheic dermatitis, etc. Unless your hairs are, or your scalp is very dry, then only use oil. According to me, coconut oil is one of the best, and especially virgin coconut oil is the best for oiling the scalp and hair. You can take a little warm oil, apply from the roots to the tips of the hair. You can pull a shower cap over your scalp and keep the oil overnight if you wish to, or at least 2-3 hours before shampooing. Now, if you do not want to apply oil on the hairs and scalp, then you can apply what are called as leave-on conditioners, also called as hair serums, after you have shampooed and conditioned your hairs. Now, this gives shine to the hair and these also increase the moisture content of the hair. Most of them contain what are called as silicone derivatives. Now, should you go in for hair procedures? The commonest hair procedure which most people do is using a hair dryer or a hair blower after they have washed or shampooed the hairs. Usually, it is okay if you are using it infrequently, but if you are doing it, say, on a daily basis, then they can make it with hair very dry, and that can cause the hair to become frizzy, brittle, and start breaking off from the cortex. So it's ideally not to use too much of the temperature when you are using a hair blower or a hair dryer. Second, a lot of people use ironing or to straighten the hairs. Again, the same theory, when you are using heat, it has to be moderate. Do not use the iron too frequently to straighten your hairs. Otherwise, it can cause a similar damage. Whether using perms, dyes, etc., etc., is good for hairs. According to me, dyeing, perming, etc., is harmful to the hair for the same simple reason. A lot of chemicals are used there. So, if you are coloring the hairs and if you are using a lot of ammonia and hydrogen peroxide, that too, those chemicals can make the hairs dry and make them more brittle. So you have to use softer dyes or what are called as non-chemical dyes, or one dyes which do not contain these chemicals. Nowadays, we usually advise people to use what are called as vegetal dyes or dyes made from henna, mehndi. So that too you can use them if you want to color your hairs. So lastly, whether these procedures like cysteine treatment or keratin treatment are good for your hairs. If you have very dry hairs and if you feel there is a lot of breakage because of your regular shampooing, etc., it is best to avoid these treatments. Keratin treatment, or what is called as a Brazilian hair treatment, usually uses formaldehyde almost to the strength of about 30-35%, which can damage your hairs too badly, and you can get a lot of hair loss after these treatments. So best is to avoid such treatments or harsh treatments to your hairs. Lastly, but what I feel, diet is one of the most important thing when you want to take good care of your hair. A normal balanced diet is what is good for your hairs. So your diet should contain green leafy vegetables, lot of salads, lot of pulses like moong, rajma and chana. You can take little amount of almonds and walnuts on a daily basis. If your hemoglobin is on the lower side, take lot of dates, pomegranates, jaggery, etc. You can take little flax seeds also to improve the what is called as the omega content of your hair. So all this is important when you are taking a normal diet on daily basis. Thank you for listening to me. Kindly like, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you.